Welcome to yet another episode of Success Principles by Successful Principals. For the ones who know me, my name is Kamalneet Singh. For the ones who don't know me, my name is still Kamalneet Singh. The name doesn't change, right? I'm really excited about this episode. And in fact, the entire journey of Success Principles by Successful Principals. This project is very, very close to my heart. And I'm glad that we are able to reach out to different parts of the world with the project. And we are able to make a difference to parents and their kids. They say that every father is a superman and every mother a superwoman, and conscious parenting is their true superpower. And if every parent can, you know, dive into their superpower and utilize it to the best potential, it makes a huge difference to their life and the life of their kids. And on this journey, I'm very thankful that we have different educators from across the world who have joined us for this initiative. And on the episode today, we have a very, very special guest with us today. And I know that you as viewers, you would want to hear more inputs as to how you can make your parenting journey a cherished one. So let me give you a little brief about who do we have with us today. I'm really excited that we have with us today the principal of DPS Kalyanpur, Mrs. Archana Nigam. Madam, thank you very much for your time. And, you know, so I'll give you a little brief and then we dive into what you have been waiting for. So Mrs. Archana Nigam is an ardent and dynamic head of the institution and has proved herself as being creative in the field of education. She's a stalwart and versatile head, winning numerous awards in recognition of her caliber. As a mentor, philosopher, friend, and guide, she stands out in excellence and is unmatched, not only in academics, but in extracurricular activities. Her role has illumined many lives and augmented zeal of learning and competing in them. Her poise and sincerity makes her the pioneer in the field of education. Her genius was recognized also in the field of music, where she rendered notes of high quality. Her multifaceted personality is an incessant source of inspiration to both the teachers and students. The reverence she gets is an example of her excelling in her field and dedication intermixed with respect and love from all those she inspires and guides at DPS Kalyanpur. You know, a very powerful educator, a very passionate educator, and all the viewers out there, you know, it is a privilege that we have, Mrs. Nigam with us. Now, all the parents out there, especially, you might want to have a pen or a pencil or a notepad to probably write down the best of the ideas so that you can later implement them. Madam, it is indeed an honor for us to have you on the show. Thank you very much. So, Madam, you have dealt with parents. I have been speaking to teachers, kids, and parents, you know, all these years. You know that generally parents have this desire and they're rightful in their desire. कि हमारे जो बच्चे हैं यू नो दे शुड बिकम सक्सेसफुल ह्यूमन बीइंग्स. हमारे बच्चे जो हैं दे शुड रियली टर्न आउट टू बी सक्सेसफुल. नाउ बट व्हाट द रियल लाइफ ऑफर्स इज वेरी डिफरेंट, राइट? हाउ किड्स आर एट अ सर्टेन एज एंड हाउ रियल लाइफ इज कैन बी डिफरेंट. सो व्हाट इज योर टेक ऑन व्हाट डज इट टेक फॉर अ चाइल्ड टू बी सक्सेसफुल इन द रियल लाइफ?
अकॉर्डिंग टू मी द चाइल्ड नीड्स टू बी वेरी कॉन्फिडेंट. And this confidence we give with the help of the environment which we are providing to the children. The children should be able to trust people. And this confidence and trust should be imparted from the staff, from the teachers, from the parents, from the environment in which they are interacting with their social well-being. So that way, in case, like if the child is very confident, so I think that is the biggest mantra for him to be successful in life. So that he is able to adapt himself to any circumstances. And in that case, if he's confident enough, so he will be able to fight with the right, with the wrong, whatever, and he can decide things for himself, making him basically very independent.
I think that's an important message coming out. So all the parents out there, what I picked up is confidence is the key that will open a lot of doors. Madam, are we on the same page?
Yeah, sure.
And, you know, while all the parents out there, I know that your focus is on academics as well. But remember that confidence is going to play an important role in their entire journey. Now, madam, you started your journey, and then today you head an institution which is renowned all across the country and has earned a lot of reputation for all the good stuff and all the initiatives that are being taken. Why don't you share with us as to what, because we're talking about success on the show, right? We're talking about how we can really be successful. The meaning can be very different for different people. So why don't you share with us as to how, what helped you in becoming successful? What helped you in rising up? Maybe a few mantras from your life.
Again, I had always believed in myself, in my own creations, and never believed in copying the things. So basically, a lot of creativeness was there while working in whatever field I was working, whether it was academics or any other extracurricular activity also. So with the help of a lot of creativity, the team was always inspired to do better, and then they could produce the best. So I had always believed in having a deeper understanding of things, and then, you know, creating those things with whatever surroundings which we come across and we see. So whatever is best for the children, we adapt those things accordingly in the school. And according to that, when we work, we have seen the results. We get the best results when we are creating things on our own and when the whole team is involved in those creations. So ultimately, it brings a lot of positivity in the environment, and everyone feels that they are growing and they have done something. So this feeling of achievement makes the things better and even greater. Wonderful. So I think that basically was my philosophy of learning and doing the things on my own understanding, rather than just copying and then, you know, pasting them here and there. So that was it.
So I think all the parents out there, the point to catch is that originality and the individual ideas are the key. So, you know, what you can also borrow from the conversation is that you can let your child, you know, do things independently the way he is doing it and work on his original ideas. And yet I also picked up some words on your personal success mantra. So self-belief is the key. Creativity is the key. You also spoke about teamwork. So they say that, you know, teamwork makes the dream work. So I think that's happening pretty much there. And originality. So these are some key words that I picked up. Now all the parents, they want ki hamare bachon ke liye, you know, every, I think deep in their hearts, they want ki hamare bachon ke liye jo best ho paaye, you know, whatever we can do, we must do. And that's a desire of every parent. Now, what would be your, you know, some top suggestions or maybe top three ideas that you would want to give to parents that can make a difference in their parenting journey?
The children should be taught the art of balancing things in life. They should learn how to pick on priorities and work upon them. It's not this like if they are playing, so they are neglecting their studies. If they are very good at studies, so they should not be playing. So all those things. So at different times, we need to prioritize the things according to the requirements and the demand. While the child is growing in the school age, in the college age, and whatever. So if the child learns this art of balancing things in life, I think things become very easy for him, because then there is no overlapping of the things, and the child is focused. The child gets that attention, that focus on everything, whatever he wishes to do in life. Plus, he is also not, you know, the parents are happy, the teachers are happy, and, you know, he's doing that way good enough and well in life. The second is that the child should be learning this art again of, I believe a lot in creativity, creating their own things. And the teachers should be the motivators and, you know, inspiring the children to create their own things, whatever they like. So we identifying those passions of the children, directing them towards, you know, those passions. The parents do understand that what is the passion of the child, and the parents should be motivating and focusing on what the passions of the children are, so that they get full support from their mentors and also from their parents. If the child is working on the passion, the things will be much more easier in life, rather than, you know, forcing things upon them. The third thing, the child should also learn how to interact socially with the people, and also develop certain traits of, you know, being a good human being and a social being, a successful social being. That is, you know, many people do not have the habit of, you know, hearing. A child, a patient listener, an active listener, is also able to achieve much in life. When the children know that they only have to speak, they don't have to listen. So those culture, that environment also has to be there in the home, in the school. So that when the children are learning and they are interacting with the people, they also develop this art. Then only they can be successful in life. So basically, they should be more balanced in nature, very creative in nature. And then, a patient listener also is one of, which you really find, and most of the people avoid this. But then again, this is also a very good trait for success.
Wonderful inputs. And so let me see if my almonds are working well or not. I'll try and recall what you said. Badam dekhte hain kitna kaam kare. So the first thing that you did mention was that it has to be a fine balance and between what they are doing, their studies, their non-academics and whatever they are doing. So balance is the key. You spoke about that, and then you also spoke about creativity. So all the parents out there, a message is also very loud and clear that let your child come out with his original ideas and do things creatively. You never know, what he ends up creating, and you will be surprised with their creativity. Passion is another thing that really stood out. Time and time again, all the educators are saying the same thing. This is one common point that's coming out. And parents, you'll have to really pick this up, because ab aisa nahi hai ki har bar main hi bol raha hu. Different educators are giving the same point, that identify the passion of your child and let him, and maybe support him in building his life around his passion. If that can happen, a child will live a happy life. And in the end, I missed the last one. If you can help me recall the last one.
Patient hearing.
Correct. So, patience wali baat pe ho sakta, probably parents are, smiling and laughing. But yes, patience is the key. And they say, agar patience hogi to fir life mein na patient nahi banna padega. And I think patience is the key. Got that. So now, I know that the competition is increasing. We cannot turn a blind eye to that. Technology is coming in. You see that last 2 years, things have been very different. Imagine we are having this conversation on a screen, on a online platform. Going forward, things will change more. And to say that it's not going to be competitive would be unfair. And what's your take? What should kids learn at an early life? What skills should they pick up at an early life that will give them an edge when they really go out in the real world?
Can you repeat the question?
I'll repeat that. I'm saying the competition is increasing. Everybody okay. wants to move ahead. Everybody wants to stay ahead of the pack. But what is it? What skills can kids learn early? What skills can they pick up at an early age that will give them an edge when they go out in the real world?
Actually, a holistic form of education helps the child achieve many things. And now, since we have these changing trends of teaching, hands-on experience and experiential learning, a lot of discovery and exploring. And we know that the children learn best when they are motivated and inspired. So the environment of the classroom should be inspiring and motivating, so that the children are able to develop their emotional understanding better, their intellectual development should be there, plus their environmental values should be embedded in the children. So if we are giving this kind of a holistic education to the children, if they adopt and they acquire these skills right from the very beginning stages, so they will be able to come up with a very confident personality, and they will be better citizens and better social well-beings and social human beings, and more adaptable and more exploring and more successful.
So holistic development is the key.
So holistic development. So we need to connect the children with the plants, environment and animals. Socially, they need to learn the art of connecting with each other and also being sensitive towards them. So we take various projects in the schools, like, for Ganga, we have taken Prayas Ganga ke Astitva ke liye. We celebrate the environmental week we celebrate the animal day and you know the different animals, we talk about them and how we need to be very sensitive towards the animal and what should, how the children should treat the animals, because you know there's a lot of misconceptions and like the children are not very clear about how they should be doing these things. So we connect them with this. We are holding assemblies, we are conducting classes, we are conducting also small workshops to sensitize the children. So once we sensitize the children, naturally, I mean, if they are like growing up, field is good. So then naturally they will be able to acquire things much better in life and they will be more successful in life.
Which I'm sure gives your students a very broad view to learn different aspects. But what I really picked up was that, you know, the importance of being able to connect with people.
Emotional understanding.
Emotional understanding, and at the same time also having the social skills. You know, so both the sides are important. So all the parents out there, you know, it's time that I you know, bother you a bit. So all the parents who say, you know, number aane chahiye hai, mujhe to sirf number chahiye. We have a very seasoned educator with us who is sharing with you that it's holistic development which is the key today. So while academics are important, at the same time, you know, kids having social skills, kids having emotional understanding, being sensitive to others' needs, that will play an important role in times to come. So these are crucial inputs coming from you. And I'm sure school is taking a lot of initiatives, as you shared, you know, under different projects, wherein kids get a very broad view and a holistic exposure. Now, if you have to, you know, assuming that if you have to give a message to all the kids, not only of your school, but, you know, all the kids at large, what would your message be for the students out there?
I would just say that we follow your passion.
Follow
your in life and go ahead with that. So automatically success will be in your hands.
So follow your passion is the mantra.
Mm-hmm.
Great. So parents out there, you know, aapne ye nahi bolna hai ki main doctor hoon to tumhe bhi doctor banna hai, right? This is on a lighter note. So the mantra that's coming out is that let the kids follow their passion.
It will be easier for them to work on that.
Got it. So you know, so very crucial inputs coming in, and I'm sure all the viewers out there, all the parents out there, you got your ideas, and that gives you a fresh lens to look at the whole aspect of parenting. Because what I firmly believe is that, you know, one shift in your way of operating, in your way of, you know, raising your kids, can give a different shift, a different angle, and a different direction to their life. So, madam, thank you very much for your inputs, and these were crucial inputs, and I'm sure all the parents would put them to use, because knowledge, if not put to use, doesn't help. I know parents, they know that. And these are inputs that will help everybody. So thank you for your time. And it was indeed a pleasure having you on this episode. Anything that you would like to say?
No, it was wonderful interacting with you. And if you are taking up this initiative of, you know, spreading such strong messages across. So I think in all, it's a very good work which you are doing. So congratulations for the same.
Thank you.